Previously on AI the Somnium Files.
You still don't know?
No, not yet, but I've almost got it. Three syllables, six letters. Kodaka, right?
That's funny for multiple reasons. And now back to
AI the Horny Guy.
AI the Horny Guy.
AI the Horny Guy.
Boobies rule.
AI the Horny Guy.
Would you like to touch my man's nut?
Boo, 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 boo. AI the Horny Guy.
Pervy Dante incoming.
AI the Horny Guy.
Hello!
This is NicoB. Back with some more AI the Somnium Files. When we last left off, we learned that Mizuki is fucking jacked. Or at least we're about to learn how she became so jacked. Because now she's going to learn karate in this sweet dojo. Yeah, she looks so cute, her little karate gi.
I'm ready to mess some stuff up.
I wonder if I've got one on too. I can't look down at myself. But anyway, a lot happened last episode, including Date doing what Date does and just making really stupid decisions. Oh, God damn it. That part fucking hurt me, man. I think it just, the reason why that bothered me so much was just the fact that I thought it was stupid the first time around. And now it's like, I gotta go through it again, but in another instance. I was really holding out hope that Date was just gonna be like this. This time though, he actually caught on to it. And he grabs the lock and he smacks Oda in the face. But one concern I'm seeing from you guys, and I just want to make perfectly clear that I'm not like condemning these characters for the rest of the game, right? I'm not like, no, that's it. Iris and Oda are, they're just done. I don't give a shit what they do or any sympathetic moments they might eventually have. It's, they're done with Amei or something. No, it isn't the case. In fact, I'm almost positive now that's going to happen because so many people are obviously, you know, like when I shit all over them. I'm just waiting for that, all right? I'm just waiting for it. I think I can already see where a lot of it will stem from, at least, especially with Oda, right? With his mom having dementia, father's passed away, Yakuza fucked them over, business is dead. There's a lot of shit going on with that. With Iris, you know, similarly, her mom fell in love with an assassin and got shot to shit at some point. You know, like, I feel definitely more sympathetic for the parents, but it's not for the kids yet. So, I don't know. We'll see. We'll see where it goes from here. I did also see quite a few of you say, like, Nico, the whole idea of using dreams to stop somebody from, like, leaving the station. I was saying, like, why do they hold Iris when she has all these thoughts of all the Cyclops victims, as well as her, like, killing animals? Or, well, it just showed animals dying in this sort of, like, artistic way. But it was pretty fucking obvious what it was trying to say. But they're like, well, you can't arrest somebody based on thoughts. At most, you would just see a psychiatrist or something for some deeply messed up mental shit. The reason why I was arguing this is because they were saying before how there's no way that Iris could have had these thoughts unless she was there for the crime, right? It was actually there, which just made me surprised then if we have something that is that sure about somebody, like how somebody's dreams are set up. Like, yes, I understand that the dream itself isn't the actual event, right? And it's made up of memories, which maybe they're fake, but they usually draw on real things. Again, it seems like it's something that should be enough to hold somebody on and investigate further instead of letting him go out in the world and murder everybody. But I guess in the end, it's just not solid enough, right? It's just such a wishy-washy, weird system anyway, that something like that just couldn't possibly be upheld. So I'll concede that that's not viable, all right? Holding somebody on back on their dreams. We could even argue with like Iris, well, she saw it on the news and she had bad dreams about it or something. I think what really just kind of got me was when like both the boss and Pooter were like, she had to have been there for it, right? It's like, there's no other way she could have had these dreams unless she was there for it. And that's why I was just like, well, why don't we fucking hold her if that's the case? I get also that we're not looking for the old Cyclops killer. We're looking for the new ones since we already have the old one. But I feel like to say that these two cases aren't tied together in some way, I think would be incorrect. But then again, I guess I don't exactly have strong evidence for that either. So anyway, I'm gonna stop fucking around with the damn dream shit and I'm just gonna have to accept it, all right? It doesn't work here. And honestly, if we had a device like this in real life, it probably wouldn't work that way either. Also, you guys did tell me a few other things. One thing is that when Mizuki said that Date didn't have a girlfriend for 4 years, it didn't mean that he actually had one before that. It just meant that that was the time that she started to live with him. So she doesn't actually know if he's ever had a girlfriend, right? So don't really focus that much on it. Okay, gotcha. It's always you hear stuff like that and you think it's trying to insinuate something. And honestly, I think the way they phrased that could have probably been a bit better, right? But okay, cool. Not a big deal. I won't worry about that then. Oh, right. And also, it turns out that in the other path that we took where everybody fucking dies, there actually were two cars parked out the outside of the where Oda was. It wasn't like they were both gone when I came. We just didn't examine it at all because I guess it didn't really matter much by that point, right? Oda and Iris were dead. And I guess that just didn't matter that much that route. But they were there. So it wasn't like if somebody was there, they got in one of those cars and drove off. And that was it. Oh, and the other thing. Some of you were apparently shocked that I didn't notice this when I really didn't think it was super obvious what was going on. Especially just the way it was angled. But when the blue person was lying on top of So, it actually showed that So's body was like sewed up versions of, like, I think the four victims with So at the head, right? You actually see apparently had two giant bazongas for a chest. I couldn't really tell, like, what was going on because the way the arms were kind of set along on top of So, it kind of looked like, I don't know. I didn't really understand what I was looking at. I was like, was he wearing a robe? I couldn't tell that was what was happening, honestly. I think it probably would have helped if Dante or somebody had actually said what was going on, like, there, but they didn't comment on it either. We're just like, oh yeah, this is making out with So.
But anyway, last episode, Solaris998 said,
Dante earlier, Mizuki is 12. There's no way she could move a body. Meanwhile, Mizuki, the jack 12-year-old lifting 220 pounds effortlessly, could crush Dante's skull with her bare hands. Yeah, we sort of learned that, that whole argument is totally tossed out the window. Mizuki's a fucking god. She's so jacked. She did like 100 reps. Didn't need anybody to spot her. I like to imagine that, like, at all times, Mizuki's just kind of holding back. Like, she looks like a normal 12-year-old girl, but then when she just starts to flex a little bit, her whole fucking shirt just goes, her sleeves just, like, rip open. It's like, fuck! No wonder Dante's so terrified of her. But anyway, Solaris, thank you so much for your hilariously accurate comment. And it is for that reason you are comment today. Okay, sorry. No, that was a mouthful. There was a lot to address, though, and I know a lot of you guys are, I think, just getting kind of fed up with me talking about the fucking Somnium. Like, it's this hard evidence that should be admissible in court, but so I'm gonna stop talking about it now. I think you're right. I'm being too unrealistic with the idea that that could really be used as actual hard evidence. When dreams are fucking weird, all right?
All right, so anyway, we flash back in time. Iris, or Mizuki is about to learn Kung Fu. We're gonna learn how she got so strong. This is so cute though, I don't know. I like the music too.
Tree. Let's look at the stuff, a Shinto shrine. It looks rather solemn. Guardian dog statue. Oh, come on, we gotta comment on something funny, right? Oh, I said lantern. I think I prefer interns. A lantern. Monument.
What does it say?
When riding an elevator, mashing the door close button doesn't actually do anything. That's what it says.
You're lying, aren't you?
See, like, Mizuki and Date's interactions are the best in the entire game, all right? I'm gonna just throw that out there. And the person voicing Mizuki is amazing. Like, holy shit. The dub in this game is really, really good. Like, I legitimately think it's one of the best dubs that Uchikoshi has gotten for any of these games. Like, everybody's just doing a bang-up job. There's something great here, but I can't read it. Chozuya.
Hey, Date, what's that?
It's a Chozuya. This is where you wash your belly button in the sacred water before you visit the shrine.
Belly button?
Yes, absolutely. In Shinto, the belly button is said to be the dirtiest place. That is why, before praying, you have to cleanse yourself.
I see. My belly is holy.
Oh my god, this is so fucking funny, man. It's so cute.
I didn't mean for that to rhyme.
Aw, that's so cute. He's like, he's just kind of fuck with her a little bit, but hey!
Date, I wish you wouldn't lie to her while she's impressionable. Your story about the belly button, she trusts you, you know.
She'll catch on eventually.
Wash your hands, your face, you're definitely not your belly button. It's kind of interesting, actually. She does seem more tolerant of Date in this flashback, doesn't she? I feel like current Mizuki would have heard that and immediately said, no, you're full of shit. Like, I'm not sure exactly how long ago this was supposed to be taking place. Mokujin. A training dummy. That's what Joker trained on. Okay. All right, Mizuki. So you look skeptical. Mental preparation is important. The key to victory is to kill the heart. Being quick to act is crucial. Your everyday life is of dire importance.
Mental preparation is important.
In a fight, you must first be victorious in your mind.
Like thinking I'm not gonna lose?
Exactly. I do the same mental preparation before going to a strip club. Before I go in, if I tell myself that they're all out of my league, then they will be. The mental fight has begun the moment I put my hand on the door.
Yeah, I see.
What? She's into it?
Actually, no. That's stupid.
There we go.
The key to victory is to kill the heart.
Like, when you get into a fight, aim for the heart?
No, get a keyblade and kill it with Donald and Goofy.
No, it's the opposite. You must kill your own heart, Mizuki.
What do you mean?
If you are going to fight, you must suppress any mercy or emotional attachment. If you have even a mote of sympathy within you, it will be impossible to fight to your potential.
Now I'm gonna show you some Mortal Kombat fucking fatalities, all right? You're gonna be doing this shit later.
Do not think of your opponent as a man. Think of them as a target, a punching bag or a board.
Piece of meat that needs butchering.
Just a punching bag. Huh.
Being quick to act is crucial.
Mizuki, do you know how to win any fight against any opponent?
Don't get in a fight in the first place?
That is a respectable answer, but no.
Good answer, but not quite.
The way to win any fight is this. Hit them first, and hit them hard enough to finish them.
Dante, are you just like encouraging Mizuki to go assault people? Yes, you get in a verbal argument. Hit first, fuck it. Go for the jugular. If they fight you afterwards, that's their problem, right? Self-defense is bullshit, fuck you.
I kinda get it, but...
Of course, I'm not saying that's how you should behave. But thinking about this will make a big difference in a real fight.
Why is Dante in charge of this job?
Yeah, okay, I get it, but... Seriously, Dante, are you like acting or something?
Not Dante, Master.
Mizuki, mad. Your everyday life is of dire importance.
What? Why?
The best training you could ever have is to be mindful during your everyday life. Diet and exercise form a strong body. And if you are always maturing intellectually and emotionally, you will always be able to anticipate your enemy's first move.
I get it. But you're so messy. Does that mean you can't fight?
Hark, the blowing of the wind through the trees.
You can't just say something cool to avoid my question.
Anyway, practice these four truths, and you will get stronger.
This sounds like a scam.
Alright, fine, then here's some fucking creatine, some dumbbells, and some workout videos, alright? Just fucking go ham.
Believe in me. If you do as I say, you'll be thanking me in time.
Are you sure?
Not really.
But how about we do a baseline test? Show me what you've got.
Huh? How?
Let's see. How about you throw a punch? I can guess your strength from that.
If you say so, I'll give it a shot.
He's gonna punch him right in the balls. Uh-oh.
First, close your eyes and concentrate.
Okay, no, I still have my same outfit on.
Exactly. Then... punch forward.
Oh god, Dante.
What?
What the fuck?
How is that?
Oh my god. What the fuck? That was unexpected. Slightly terrifying. I was like, what? Dante's reaction is the same as mine. What the fuck did I just bear witness to? Okay, apparently, Mizuki's already jacked. Doesn't need any help. She's basically Saitama. Oh my god. Did I just feel the fucking air?
You don't have to be nice. I know I'm weak.
Hey, by the way, Did you swing back at those bullies?
No, I didn't do anything. There were a bunch of them. I didn't think I could.
I see. She doesn't know her own strength.
I suppose not.
I don't want to get hit by her.
Mizuki, let's just say I think you should be more confident in yourself.
I mean, I don't know if you should punch him with that much strength. Maybe hold back a little bit, because I think if you do, you're going to literally cut them in half.
Really?
But never, ever strike your master. That is a must.
Please. Please! Hurt them, not me!
Yeah, you're right.
So ridiculous! So, oh my gosh, just canonically is normally already like stronger than most adult males and bodybuilders. She can create a shockwave with her fucking fist.
In fact, you're so strong you scare me sometimes.
Well then?
No, I can't take you with me.
Why not?
Because I took responsibility for you. I promised Renju. I can't put you in danger.
Ah, fuck that, dude. I'd be like, Mizuki, you're coming with me. You're my secret weapon. Nobody's gonna think that this little 12-year-old girl is actually She-Hulk in disguise.
That's not fair. Bringing up Daddy.
Iris and Ota feel the same way. They don't want you hurt either. You have to understand, Mizuki. If I need your help, I'll let you know. When the time comes.
I want to see Mizuki kick some fucking ass now. Jesus. You're gonna give her this sweet demon power. You gotta give her something to use it on, alright? She's gonna come in and fuck up these mafia dudes. Like, literally punch the bullet back at them. Good God.
Really?
Yes.
Promise?
I promise.
Aww.
Let's go, Iva.
Where to?
Aw. I feel bad. You know what? Normally I'd be like, yeah, let's not take her with us, but... No, she's fine. She'll be totally fine. She can one punch literally anything, just like Saitama. Okay, I guess we're all done then. Just gotta wait for somebody to wake the fuck up, right? I'm gonna come back, boss is over here just murdering and pillaging some more. I'm like, God damn it, boss. I know, I just the worst.
Before we reach HQ, let's summarize our investigation so far.
Okay, but first, let's see if there's anything hilarious in here.
Boxing gloves.
Hey, there we go. Little box, boxing gloves.
A boxer puts his boxing gloves in the glove box.
Pons, pons. Uchikoshi loves his wordplay, doesn't he? Okay, that's pushing it. Rear view window.
Mirror, mirror in the car. Who is the most handsome policeman by far? Why, that is Mr. Date, of course.
Date, this is starting to concern me. You really should get some sleep.
I really need to give you more medication.
Shut up. Stop talking about my secret medication that I shouldn't know about. Dashboard.
These are tasty when they're golden brown.
Oh, yeah.
I believe you're referring to hash browns.
Okay, that's not even that close. Come on. Dashboard, hash brown. That's not that close, Date. Come on. Come on. Maybe that's the best thing we could think of. I feel like some of these, I mean, they can't translate perfectly over to English, right? It's like, wonder what did he normally say when he looked at the dashboard in Japanese? Do they even have hash browns in Japan? Is that even a thing that they would eat over there? Seems like more of an American thing. Oh, wait. Gear shift. No, nothing fun. Wait, I like manuals more than automatic. Oh. Passenger seat. Damn, no wonder I didn't see this thing before. Look how far down there it is. All right, I think that might be it. All right, we had some funny stuff that time, at least. Good. We are learning. I have us sitting in the passenger seat. Well, to be precise, an image of her sitting in the passenger seat. About Mayumi.
Mayumi is suffering from dementia. If Mayumi followed Ota and Iris...
I legitimately think I'm going to have an ending... Or a branch in this game where fucking Mayumi stabs me. She's gonna stab me or stab somebody with that knife of hers, right? They keep showing her and having talk about the knife that was given to her by Oda. It's totally gonna happen. I actually think it might likely happen in the ending where Oda and Iris are both dead already. And she's already pissed at Date. She's just gonna come out and fucking stab the shit out of me.
It is highly likely that she saw the person in the polar bear costume, but...
She might not remember.
Correct.
Oh. That's what we're saying. That's what we're saying with the two vehicles. I didn't really understand what was going on with the two cars being there. What we're saying is that Ota's mom followed them to the warehouse, I think. So she could have seen the person in the polar bear outfit. I think. I was like, wait, what are we talking about? If Miyumi followed Ota and Iris. Yeah. So that's why the two cars are there? Is that what we were trying to suggest? I thought they said both of them had Ota's, like... No, wait. Hold on. But I thought the van... I'm sort of confused because if I'm remembering correctly, and I could be wrong, I thought the van had both Ota and Iris's, like, DNA in it, right? Iris is in the passenger, Ota was in the driver's seat. And then the stolen car had Ota's DNA in it as well. Or was Miyumi in one of those... What? Do we mention Miyumi at all? Okay, I just went back to confirm because I'm like, am I losing my mind? They didn't. They mentioned nothing about Miyumi. Why are we saying that she could have followed them there? I don't even know where that line of thought is coming from. It's highly likely that she saw the person in the polar bear costume? Why? What are we basing that off of? I feel like I'm being an idiot, but I'm assuming that she was the polar bear was in the car with them in the van or something? It wasn't like they were kidnapped out of the house, right? Like by the polar bear. I think it was shown that they drove off. But and it mentioned nothing about like Miyumi like following them in a car. I don't know, you guys can tell me. I'm sure I'm missing something. But I really don't remember, like there was nothing mentioned about Miyumi's DNA being in some of the cars. They said the most recent was Ota and Iris in the van, and then Ota stole the car. I'm still confused by that though, because it was like, well, why did he need to steal a car if he already had a car? Unless he left or something. Or got picked up by Miyumi, maybe? And then he stole a car and came back? Okay, let's just keep talking.
There is only circumstantial evidence linking Sosajima to the new Cyclops serial killings.
I agree, but there has to be more to it. The Kumakuras had connections to both victims. So has a connection to the Kumakuras. There's a common link there. They have to be involved somehow. So also might have connections to Iris.
Because So appeared in Iris's Somnium?
Yeah, so it's like his head is like sewed onto a whole bunch of dead bodies.
Yeah. I am more interested in the hired guns that So uses as bodyguards. I did some research and discovered that Mr. Sajima hires substantial security.
That guy was also voiced by Kyle Hebert.
If all of his security staff are this heavily armed, Yakuza gangs pale in comparison.
Is So trying to start trouble?
Unknown, but there is definitely more than he is letting on.
About Mizuki.
Mizuki did not have any new information about Okiura Fishery. Currently, it seems there is nothing linking that company to Renju.
Still, something's not right.
I'm exhausted.
Likely because you haven't had a good night's sleep.
Yeah, it's been a while since I've been this busy.
If my body were made of flesh, I would offer my lap as a pillow.
Oh my god.
What? You can't say something like that out of the blue. Now it's awkward.
I can't tell if I'm actually secretly, like, actually does love Dante or something. She keeps saying that she's doing all this stuff for him, like this is what he would like, but he doesn't seem to be into it at all. And he seems kind of weird out by her. We're gonna give Iba a body, and that's gonna be the canon ending of this game. I mean, Iba and Dante gonna fuck. All right, any other information?
There is an important piece of news.
What is it?
The Odoroki man chocolate found at the warehouse. Fingerprints were found on it.
Whose?
Mayumi Matsushita's.
What?
Mayumi bought the chocolate at the convenience store 812 on Koshu.
Oh.
This was captured on security footage. 812 stores are commonly called eights. Eight is not far from the Famisto where Ota stole the station wagon.
What? Did we jump the gun or something? Or am I? I don't know, man. I'm like so like conflicted because I feel like I'm saying this shit and people are like, well, obviously Nico, you're just a fucking idiot. And I'm like, which is why I'm afraid. I'm like trying to wrap my head like, wait, am I? Is there something I'm missing? I feel like I missed something here. Like, this seems like this is the information we needed first, right? Like, this is why we could have said Miyumi saw the polar bear, because her fingerprints were on the food, which was the same food taken from the convenience store where the car was stolen, right?
Hold on a second. I'm having trouble keeping the facts straight.
Allow me to summarize.
Please.
The chocolate was purchased yesterday at 10:33 p.m.
That's the same time Ota stole that car.
Correct.
What conclusions can we draw from that?
They were together.
All that is known for certain is that Mayumi bought the chocolate at an 8 store last night, and that same chocolate somehow ended up in the warehouse.
Did she go there and drop it?
It is possible.
Well,
I swear to God, this information was like they fumbled their information there. Like this is oh, there's the connection. That's why more than likely Miyumi saw the guy in the polar bear outfit. Like, it assumed that I already had this information, even though I didn't actually have it. But I'm gonna just throw out there, I could be completely wrong. If I am wrong, please point it out to me. I'm not trying to be like a smartass or anything. I just legitimately do not remember the idea that Miyumi could have been there ever being brought up. But this seems like the connecting evidence, and now we're just like kind of reacting to it. It just seems funny. Just like they did it out of order or something.
Sorry to interrupt your brainstorming, but there's a call from the boss.
Connect me.
Hook me up.
Date. Hear that Iris's operation is over?
Hey!
Yeah, I heard about it at the hospital. She made it, right?
Yes, but she's still unconscious. She's currently in the ICU. No visitors allowed.
Wake the fuck up, bitch!
Alright.
Ota, however, seems like he can talk now.
Oh, good. Okay, hold on. I'm gonna go there, but I need to stop somewhere first. I got some things I need to pick up.
Pick up?
Yeah, a taser and a walk. Hey, Ota! Ota, I bought you a little gift, Ota.
He's out of treatment?
Yeah, he's in a general ward now.
Got it. I'll head over.
What?
I'll meet you there.
I'm just walking. Boss is just smothering Ota with a pillow. I'm like, God damn it, boss. I swear to fuck. Okay, cool. Central Hospital.
How are you feeling, Ota?
Welcome back from the demon dead, asshole.
You know, surprisingly, I'm feeling pretty good.
How about now? What?
I'm still under anesthesia, so I don't have any pain.
All right, that's good.
Ota, I'm sorry to put this on you right after your surgery, but can you talk to us for a minute?
Maybe because you're loopy on anesthesia, you're more likely to talk to us about shit. Boss got right to the business after introducing herself. I don't know why, but Ota seemed almost happy to answer. Yeah, yeah. Maybe it was the drugs, but maybe it was the high from surviving a life or death situation. Maybe it's because he saved Iris.
Yeah, sure.
Most likely the drugs. Yeah, dude, yeah, you know, you just get him on. I got you. I'll tell you all about the shit. All right. LCD
hey,
TV.
Date, when are you planning on leaving? The good stuff is going to come on soon.
You're not watching that tonight.
What the fuck? What good stuff? Good stuff's coming on soon, and I got the lotion right here. What the fuck are you talking about? Bedside table.
Is it bedside table when you move it away from the bed?
I suppose then it's just a table.
Oh my god. Stop! Bed.
Hey, Date. I don't think I can sleep by myself tonight.
Uh-oh.
Will you sleep with me?
Ota, I swear to fuck, alright? Do you want to get walked again?
Why me?
Oh, then that old woman over there is fine.
Old woman?
Holy fuck. And you want to die today? Boss is not that old. Is she? Wait, how old is Boss again? Oh, hey, we got updates. Oh, she's fucking 42? I mean, it's not that old, but even then. Damn, girl, look good. Some flapjacks. Sorry. I don't care if you're crazy. I'll take it. Takaro Matsushita. So, 55, deceased. Owner of the Matsushita Diner. Likes Miyumi, Ota, Matsushita. Sorry, I'm just imagining my head. Likes Miyumi, Matsushita Diner. Dislikes Ota. I'm sorry. I know that sketch kind of me, but I'm sorry. I'm getting this funny shit out, right? Until Ota gets that sympathetic moment, which is likely going to be in the next like 5 minutes, right? I'm just getting all that funny shit out there. I'm just shitting on Ota while I still can't. Dislike customers who don't finish their food. Hobbies fishing shogi. Skills backflips, throwing knives. Takaro is an ardent student of cooking and very particular about the ingredients he uses. Therefore, his diner attracted many customers but did not make a significant profit. Helping Miyumi was his first priority, decreasing his focus on the diner. Ah, okay. Helping Miyumi was his first priority. So that probably means that Miyumi was already suffering from dementia even before he had passed away, right? Before he died. So, yeah. And I think he died. He died of a heart attack, I think. That's what the myocardial thing was just basically saying, a heart attack. So I don't think any of that really had anything to do with, like, the fallout from, like, the chemical plant going down. I think it just happened to throw it on top of other things that's... I think it's just an additional thing. I don't think they're necessarily connected, right? But it still is just a number of really bad things happening to the Matsushita family all at once. Bodyguard. Age unknown. Likes boobs and erotic novels. Dislikes men, males, testosterone. I'm a manly man. Brr. Hobbies, swimsuit magazines. Skills, self-defense. He's one of those many bodyguards. Even though they look alike, they are not clones. They all wear face masks to hide their identity. That's the mask he's wearing? They're all the same dude with the same generic likes. Patient monitor. Equipment used for monitoring vital signs. Measures heart rate, blood pressure, and body temperature on the monitor. Boss is staying on the other side of the bed. Why'd you come here?
I'm kind of interested in Ota.
In me?
You protected the woman you love. That's not easy to do.
That's kind of hot.
I wanted to meet the brave little hero.
Hero?
Little? I'm 24.
To me, you're still little.
Bitch! Your age is my numbers in reverse!
Did you find new clues?
If I did, I would have told you already.
Thanks. Anything you want to ask Oda?
I'll leave this to you, Date.
Thanks. Alright. Oda's lying down in bed. Did you hear about Iris?
Her surgery was successful, right?
Nah, she's fucking dead.
Yeah, thanks to you. If you weren't there, Iris would have been in real trouble.
Yeah, I was being the polar bear outfit. What? I'm just fucking with you guys.
I'm Tessa's biggest fan. Any fan would have done what I did. It's nothing special. It's as normal as garlic and ramen.
I think that depends on preference.
Honestly, I'm a little bit scared of my new power. When I locked eyes with that polar bear, I saw him start shaking. He saw how strong I was and got scared, no doubt.
Okay, Oda, you're just being kind of a little douchebag right now, so come on.
Ota's body temperature is rising.
Yeah, he's full of fucking shit.
He's embellishing his story quite a bit.
I think we can let that go today.
No, fuck you.
Yeah, you're right.
Get the walk. About the walk, yeah!
Oh, yeah. You hit me over the head with that walk, didn't you?
Motherfucker. And tase me in another timeline.
That was... I thought I needed to protect Tessa, so...
Isn't there something you want to say to me?
Sorry. I'm sorry.
He's like, no? I'm like, oh, you little bitch.
It's okay. But you're not gonna get a second chance.
Yeah. Next time you hit me with that, I'm gonna just leave you to bleed out.
I won't do it again. I swear on Ganesha.
You should swear to a god that's a little closer, kid.
Swear on the elephant god. All right, who stabbed you? Tell me.
Were you watching the stream? A big polar bear.
Yes, I'm talking about who was inside.
I ain't got even fingers. I don't know how to hold the knife.
Did you see them?
No. Whoever it was probably wearing that costume to hide their identity.
About that thing on Nile. Just That's... tell me, please!
Sorry. I promised that I wouldn't tell anyone.
Then I'll tell Iris about your fake accounts. You know what happens after that, right? Everything you built up here is going to come crashing down.
But I can't tell you.
Why not? Calm down and think about it. The criminal who attacked Iris is still out there. Iris might have seen the criminal's face. Whoever did this might come back to kill her.
No.
If you want to protect her, the fastest way is for us to catch this guy.
Where's the polar bear, Oda?
But to do that, I need information.
Okay.
Okay, I'll tell you. Iris was actually a Coca-Cola spokesperson. What? Yeah, and the Coca-Cola polar bear turned against her. He became sick of having to work underneath a fucking frigid bitch. So he turned on her. Fucking turned on her. Threw all of his Coca-Cola dollars away and was like, no, it's time. Time to convert to the other side. And that's when he became Pepsi Bear. God, I sure do love Pepsi-Cola. Woo! I was like, all right, that's really the truth. Donna's like, hold on a second. I need to go grab my walk again. Okay, please. Tell me.
Remember when I told you about my day Saturday? I kind of lied a little.
What did you lie about?
When I got to Sunfish Pocket, I saw a sign that said the place was all rented out. That part is true. But after that, I said I went home, but I didn't. I was hanging out in Akihabara for a few hours.
Is that when you bought your new phone?
Yeah.
Why did you hide that?
Because something happened after.
Keep going!
This must have been about 8:50. I was going to cross the intersection in Akiba, and I saw Mr. Okiura's car at the light. But when I got close, I saw Tessa driving it.
Iris was driving it?
Whoa! You surprised me!
I'm more surprised than you are! Is something wrong?
What do you mean? Hey, Tessa, do you have a license?
What are you, a cop, bitch? Are you?
Oh, yeah, of course I do. Not have one.
You don't have a license?
Shh. Mr. Okiura asked me to run an errand. I had to borrow his car. Please don't tell anyone.
Okay.
You promise?
Anything for you.
Ah, that's my good little bitch. All right, get the fuck out of here.
After that, the light turned green and she drove off.
Oh, that's not good.
Was Iris the only one in the car?
Yeah, it was just her.
I saw Mr. Akira in the back sleeping on the ground. He must have been drinking because I saw a whole puddle of red wine underneath him.
That's what I meant by that thing. An idle driving without a license is a huge deal. So I kept quiet.
Keep going.
Saturday at 6:15 p.m., Ota saw Iris and Renju together. They were leaving the Sunfish Pocket building. 2.5 hours later, Ota witnessed Iris driving Renju's car. What are your thoughts?
This is sounding really bad for Iris.
Murdered him and just drove off.
But consider the current circumstances. Iris had her left eye taken out by a criminal who is possibly the new Cyclops killer.
She probably fucking did herself.
And if Ota had not reached her in time, she would have been killed.
Yeah, that's right. I don't know who that polar bear was. Probably just one of her dorky fans in an outfit.
What is going on here?
Alright. About the Odoroki Man chocolate. I took the chocolate out of my pocket and showed it to Oda.
Does this jog your memory?
Oh, that.
What? Do you know something about it?
Hi there! Oda, how you doing? It's your old pal Monokuma! Alternate universe Monokuma! Yeah! I promise I won't put you in a killing game and murder you! I'm a happy bear of this one, despite me looking even more terrifying than my original self!
You don't have to show me the thermograph. It's written all over his face.
Absolutely.
Piece of shit! What happened after you left Masashita Donner?
You mean after hitting you with the walk?
Wah!
Yes.
Yeah.
I took Tessa in the van and we ran away. I drove for a while, then we decided to take a breather. I parked the car at Famisto on Koshu. I told Tessa I was gonna go in and buy something to drink.
Oh, okay, 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 okay.
I got out of the car and I went inside, but then I heard Tessa screaming, Ota, help! I ran out of the store as fast as I could, but the car was driving away. I looked around, and I saw there was a car with its engine still on, and...
The station wagon, right?
Yeah. Before I even realized what I was doing, I was behind the steering wheel. I didn't mean to steal it. I just needed to borrow it.
The time was 10:33 p.m. Now we know why Ota stole the station wagon.
Okay. Okay, now I understand that. So, basically, somebody supposedly stole the van. Unless Iris was just like, Ota, help! And she drives off herself.
See you, bitch.
After stealing the station wagon,
I took the car, then drove out onto Koshu, but I couldn't find the van anywhere. I searched for what felt like hours.
You didn't contact the police?
I thought after I hit you.
You shouldn't have worried about that.
But that's all that I was thinking at the time. I thought that if I called the cops, they'd arrest me.
Well, yeah.
I wasn't thinking clearly. I was panicking. And that's why I didn't realize it right away.
Realize what?
My phone. I left my new phone in the car.
Why is that so important?
Because the phone had GPS on it. If I looked it up, I would find the location of the van.
Smart.
So I drove as fast as I could to an internet cafe and looked it up. That's when I found out my new phone was at a warehouse near the water. You know the rest.
Okay. Okay. Cool. Awesome. Glad, Ota. I'm glad you weren't the simping asshole who, like, upset this stupid shit up, all right? Cool. That all matches up. I'm sure that's probably true. So what was Miyumi, like, how did she get there, right? What was up with that? Having her DNA on the chocolate.
Did you see me turn off the saw?
Yeah, but everything after that was off screen. What happened?
I honestly don't remember much. My mind went blank. I remember rushing the bear, and I think I was fighting him for a while, and we got tangled up.
Your blows tickle me, Ota! You cannot defeat me!
And then, before I knew it, he got me in the stomach with a knife.
Bitch! Eat this! Got shanked to shit by a polar bear! Who is this polar bear?
Just to make absolutely certain, you didn't see who was in the suit?
No, I didn't.
Voice? Body type?
Nothing. Sorry.
Anything at all you can remember?
I'm sorry, I told you everything. I can't think of anything else.
Are you sure?
Yes.
Date, look.
Oh, come on.
God damn it, he's still fucking lying to me.
After all this, what is he trying to hide?
Date, Ota is acting strange. I advise caution.
What do you mean?
He's jerking off. What the fuck?
I don't believe it.
He's holding a knife.
Why does he have that?
In any case, you know what you have to do now.
I know.
Shoot him!
Let me go! Let me go!
What the hell do you think you're doing?
Shut up! Just let me go!
Take this!
Sleeping gas. Now you've done it. I can't question him like this.
Somnium!
But you can still get information.
God damn it.
Inside his head.
I'm sorry, but also, where the fuck did he get this knife? I think that's a big question. How and where did he get this knife when he was in the fucking hospital? He's like, I just got up and grabbed a knife. Wait, I'm sorry, was he threatening to stab one of us or stab himself? Is this the knife that was missing from the scene?
6 minutes. Please do not go over it.
Did he somehow hide that on his person? No, I have no idea.
But are you sure this is okay? Ota just came out of surgery.
If anything happens, I'll take responsibility.
But...
it's fine. Just get it done.
Like, it wasn't like a scalpel either. It was like a kitchen knife. Where did he get that? And if it was supposed to be like the knife that stabbed him or something, how did he have it on his person when we brought him to the hospital, right? And we didn't find it. Oh, whatever. Whatever! Just roll with it. All right. Let's go fuck up Ota's weird little brain. I'm in a box.
Can you please take me with you? long as I have Wi-Fi, I don't need anything else.
Oh my god, Iba.
Sorry, we can't have pets.
Cold-hearted old man.
We gotta do a stick at the start of every one of these. Hey, this looks familiar.
Is this a cold storage warehouse?
Seems to be.
Not a manga cafe? Or an otaku shop?
Something about the Smash music is about to play in a second.
No, but a warehouse is a common
use. I thought it was about to go right into the fucking, was that Smash Brawl? I think it was the Brawl theme.
You know a lot.
Predicting this, I did some research on Ota's taste.
I see. By the way, are you smaller?
Either that, or everything else is bigger. Interesting.
Hey, that's...
Hey there, little buddy! I'm a polar bear! I'm a polar bear!
Iris is about to be...
Yeah, here we go.
Stop right there! The heavens call. The earth cries out.
Oh, God.
The crowds roar! All calling on me to strike back against evil!
God damn, he's gonna be dressed like a Power Ranger or some shit.
Hold on, Tessa! I will save you!
Nah, he just looks like Oda.
Yeah!
Ah! That front flip!
I will protect Tessa!
Is this from the stream we saw earlier?
This is Ota's memory of it. It appears to be a bit exaggerated.
Yeah, I'm the fucking best! Yeah!
Alright, let's help reproduce the memory.
Somnium scan! Activate!
Mr. Kitty, powering up! Yeah! Alright. I'm tiny. Do I not want the polar bear to see me or something? Alright, mental lock 1. 2. 3! I'm a polar bear!
I'm 4! Yeah!
Alright, there are many choices in this one. Relive Oda's memories. Reproduce the fiery battle between Oda and the polar bear. Save Iris. Save the world! Oh, God!
Curse you, polar bear! I will vanquish you!
Was that a Heroes reference?
But if I rush in, I'll slip on the ice and fall. Like this.
Just run around it, you idiot! God!
Damn it! If I go in like that, I'll have nothing to show for it! All of it amounts to nothing. What will I do?
I'm so fucked! There's absolutely no way I can solve this problem!
I don't know what that was exactly, but the knowledge you gained might be useful.
I did not want to use my local storage space for this.
I'm so tiny! Okay, no choice yet. Okay, icy floor, forklift, frozen forklift, ice cutting machine, Iris, heated installation door. I'm so tiny. Holy shit, these take so much time. Oh my god. Tackle, listen, open. So much time. Not fucking with it. Hello, Mr. Bear. I'm gonna crawl up his pooper. Just like Ant-Man, that's how he beat fucking Thanos at the end of Endgame! I can't interact with him.
The ice on the floor is slick.
Oh my god, everything takes so long. What the hell? Punch, jump, slide, lie down. Okay, it's gotta be. I see my sparkles over here. That's the eyeball. Can I actually get up there? I don't think I can. Not right now. I think these need to maybe fall over or something to form like a path.
A machine used for cutting ice.
There's gotta be some short ones, right? That can give me some timies that I can use on these. Turn on. Yeah, that's right. Turn on. They used up all my time. Kill Iris.
Iris is on the platform.
Here we go. Throw ice at her. Ears. Wake her. Ears.
Tessa's catchphrase.
Yeah, if anything is gonna make her react, it's that.
All right. Ears.
Headset, head, A-set!
God damn it!
No, not you!
Get out of here, Oda!
This will probably not help wake Iris.
But I will get some sweet timies.
Iris is on the platform.
Yeah, this is the idea behind this. And I've actually noticed, look, see, I actually get, the timies that you get are actually random. Like, see,
that one time, last time it was actually 1 second all across them, and now I've got 1 second, 10 seconds, and 1/10.
I guess it's just like generically, you're gonna get a really powerful timing here. Wake her.
Iris, hey, are you okay? Tessa!
Yeah, she's not waking up.
Iris is on the platform.
Okay, I save my big time, my timings for the good shit.
This is an ice cold one.
Just throw it.
Chuck it at her.
Yeah.
Bonk.
No good, huh?
I believe that Ota has to be the hero of this story.
And he needs a little more motivation.
All right, cool. We've got a lot of good timings now. Let's do some shit.
You've got 5 minutes.
Okay, we have the forklift. Frozen forklift.
The ice on the...
So slide, jump, punch, lie down. Slide.
Leave it to me.
Woo!
Suki?
Eros!
Good exhibition. That'll score high.
It would have been perfect if I had a tight black bodysuit.
This is your gun ice reference, maybe?
Maybe you can do a Javier Fernandez routine next.
Those who don't fight won't survive!
I guess we broke it that way. Cool. Oh, god damn! What the fuck, Oda? Oh, we do have a choice. Here we go. We actually have a choice here. Okay. Bitch! You think you can defeat me? Na 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 na. Oh my god! Battle!
Damn. He's too strong! It sucks! But this is war after all!
What is this awesome power?
Tessa! May the glory of victory be yours!
May the power of my boner give me strength!
It's over.
I suppose we have no choice but to find the glory of victory.
Porn Mac! That's it. That's what always works for me. Alright. So we've got two. Episode two. Shining Light, escort him to the green shelf. Shining Light, escort him to the red shelf. Okay, so there's that one, and then there's that one. We're gonna go with the green shelf because I want that eyeball over there.
A plate attached to the shelf. The cold has frosted over it.
Wipe off, breathe on. Probably punch.
Hey, hey. Are you upset?
I am not upset.
Hey, hey. Are you upset?
I am not upset.
Hey.
I am not.
What the fuck is this shit? This is referencing something, right? I have no idea.
Attached to the shelf.
Breathe on, wipe off. Wipe off.
I rubbed the frost off, but nothing is happening.
Okay.
A plate, a...
Breathe on. Ooh, B!
I would be happier about D.
I'm sure.
D unit! Okay. Do that to all of them then? I'm guessing so. C!
C.
I see.
Right.
Okay.
Agent Dante, you've got 4 minutes.
Don't know exactly what this is accomplishing, but I'm gonna keep doing it.
Something strange happened.
My hentai makes me strong.
What's happening?
Oh, what the hell?
Oh, that's bright.
Hey.
What is this?
Oh my god, A set power. So it was only that was the only one that really mattered, it seems like. Yeah, I just have this stuff.
We're out of options.
What the fuck?
Is that Miyumi's knife?
Is Miyumi in the polar bear outfit?
Taza!
If this was another, I would have died already.
If this was another? What?
Next time, he will get me. That's just destiny.
Shown the letter A on the shelf.
No! I will fight destiny! And win!
So he says.
I'm the one who has to help him.
We have to make Hero of Justice Ota fight back and look cool doing it.
Oh, this is interesting. Is it suggesting that Miyumi's in the polar bear outfit and she's the one that stabbed Ota? That would be some really dark shit. Like, what the fuck? I was thinking Miyumi was gonna stab somebody. I don't think it'd be Ota or somebody else that has her knife, but it did suggest that she was here, right?
Oh, fuck. Why didn't it occur to me? It didn't occur to me. Miyumi might have followed them there, right? And in order to save Ota, right, from this witch, she tried to kidnap the witch and she's the one who tried to fucking chop her in half. But maybe, when he actually stabbed him, maybe she just got confused, right? Like she forgot Ota or who he was or... I mean, she's being attacked, right? That's pretty messed up. That might be where this is going, though. How did she chase after them, though? Where did she get, like, another car and follow them? She run on foot down a fucking highway? Okay. Let us... Can I get up here yet? I don't think I can. Okay, so I see the wooden box. I'm probably gonna need a forklift for it, right? Investigate, push, break. I think I'm gonna just need the forklift. Oh, wait, no. Push it onto the forklift. I mean, that's the melee theme. I don't know. No, push to the forklift. Okay, whatever.
It doesn't move.
What's in it?
A small wooden box?
Okay, not quite. Maybe I do have to do the forklift then.
A forklift?
Sortie? Push, pray. What's sortie?
What? Sortie?
This is Ota's world, right? Your role in this dream is to assist Ota in his fight against the polar bear.
Lousy Ota. Thanks to him, my image as a cool intellectual has been destroyed.
Yeah, fuck him.
All systems green. Synchronization rate 6%.
What the hell?
Now, cargo handling car. Forklift. Sortie!
What? What? I don't want to sort it.
Hey, forklift! Fork over that weapon now!
Nani?
La 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 la! I don't know what is going on!
I can't stand. I'm weak.
Did he really help Iris like that?
We have no choice but to have Ota do it.
Yes.
We need him to stand up.
That forklift just went on its own with his mind. Okay. Bravo, hero. Disarm the foe. How do I get inside this thing? I don't know. Maybe I had to use the other shelf then to get in there. It tricked me. It made you think you had to get the green shelf to get in there, but in fact. Okay.
Ota is still down.
Motivate, encourage, calm, cheer. I'm gonna cheer him on. I don't even know how much time it takes.
Ota will feel the worth of Iris's peace when he grasps it.
The ghost inside me whispered. That's right. I can't run away now. I can't sacrifice Tessa.
Yeah!
Awaken the soul!
Good call. Oh my god! What the fuck?! This kid's crazy!
There!
Why?
Uh-oh. Oh, that's what he's been hiding. That's why he didn't want to talk about it.
Dead.
You don't want to think that, oh my god, is my mom in there? Did she stab me? Ah! Brave hero, disarm the... Oh, no, no, you're dead.
Uh-oh.
Well, we got old A. Good news. She must have been really fucking confused to stab Oda. Also, where'd she get that polar bear outfit? I think that is the case here, though. I kind of forgot how much that...
Sorry that I had to get rough with you, kid.
Sorry to beat the shit out of you, kid. I kind of forgot that Miyumi hated Iris, right? Hated her. So obviously she'd have a reason to want to, you know, scoop her up and take her somewhere and chop her in half. Okay, let's, I want to have a look at the branching paths here. So which way did I go? To the left. Hey, we're still going down the one red path. I don't know if that really matters at all. But we are going off this path, so hopefully that doesn't end in me dying. I do feel like this could be the game's subtle way of just telling you that this is the first path you should be taking, right? Potentially. For optimal gaming experience. Did anything get updated? Oh, yes, right, the album. Ota. Psh. Either Metal Gear or Pepsi Man? I don't think you remember Pepsi Man getting the giant barrel on top of his head. Pepsi Man! Oh my god, actually that'd be amazing, right? Coca-Cola Bear versus Pepsi Man in a barrel. But that just could be me having Pepsi on the brain. Because that's what it ended up being. This is what he would have looked like. He had like a buck tooth in the original concept art. It looked even more chippy than he does. He actually, they made him look like... They made him look more like his dad, right? It's kind of like, just kind of off the art style of the main cast. Sure still says geek, though. In one iteration, he actually had Kaido hair. Luminary of the Stars. Thank God they didn't keep that shit. Yeah, I think it was a better call not to go with this art style with him, because it does kind of stand out a bit. I couldn't figure out how to get the eyeball. I guess I must have needed the other path to get to it, because I don't think there's any way I could have gotten up on that shelf. At least I know where it is now.
Seriously, dude? Come on.
You had a knife on you.
So sorry, Ota. Date told me to be the bad cop.
Yeah. Yeah, dude.
I did not.
Temper, temper.
Whatever. Anyway, Ota, I have some things I want to ask you. I'm not going to beat around the bush. Let me get right down to it. Your mother, Mayumi Matsushita, was at the warehouse, wasn't she?
What are you talking about?
Was she there?
Why would she be? That happened at 3 a.m. She was at home asleep.
Then why did we find evidence at the crime scene?
Evidence?
Sure, it might not prove she was there, but it makes it likely. The evidence is...
Yeah, okay. The evidence is two cars. No, it's this. We don't actually have the kitchen pattern knife right now. That's only based off of the dream. Wait, no, look at it. I took it out of my pocket and showed him.
The Hodoroki man chocolate.
Oh, I meant to have her examine it. Oh, well, whatever.
The same one I showed you at the hospital. I found it in the corner of the cold storage warehouse.
So? That doesn't prove anything.
Mayumi's fingerprints were on the package.
What?
You have a bad poker face, Ota. Your reaction tells me Mayumi didn't give this to you and you dropped it on your own.
That information is confirmed. Ota's fingerprints were not found on the package.
Mm-hmm.
Mom isn't the killer!
I didn't say that she was. I'm saying that she was at the scene. And so were you.
Wait a minute. Why do you think Mayumi isn't the killer, Ota?
Because I was face to face with that polar bear when we fought. I could tell it wasn't my mom, even through the costume. And no matter what happened, there's no way that my mom would stab me.
But you suck, Ota. Of course you would.
Why are you covering for her?
Covering?
That's why you're lying to me, right?
I'm not.
She stabbed you to shit, Ota.
Are you sure about that? You must have seen direct evidence of Mayumi being at the warehouse.
I'm gonna go to Mayumi. I'm not gonna arrest her. I'm just gonna give her a high five and be like, yeah, my girl.
But you're hiding that from us. Or maybe even you're starting to suspect her.
I am not.
Sure.
What are you accusing me of anyway? What do you think I'm hiding?
What is Oda hiding? Okiura Fishery streaming equipment, Odoriki Man, chocolate, two cars, floral pattern. Let's look at this.
The polar bear dropped the weapon in Ota's somnium. It was the floral pattern kitchen knife. On the handle were the words, Mom, I love you always. Date. From this, we can conclude that the knife...
I know.
Yeah, it's this. He hid this somewhere, right?
The kitchen knife with a floral pattern. Mom, I love you always is carved on the handle.
Ota gave me that knife for Mother's Day when he was in elementary school. He knows how much I love flowery designs.
You know, you just knew that at some point that knife was going to get used to stab somebody, right? Right. I was not expecting it, though, to be Oda, though. I actually really thought, I was like, okay, one of these endings is going to be Miyumi using that knife on me. I think she clearly got very confused. She's like, damn it, Oda, I'm trying to save you, you stupid bitch.
You were stabbed by that very same knife.
Does that mean the other ending that she actually, like, took Oda and, like, chopped him in half, too?
How do you know that? The criminal ran away with the knife. No one was supposed to see it.
I knew it.
No, my mom didn't do it.
Then why did you not mention the kitchen knife earlier?
Because I know how it looks. I thought Mom would get accused. And then she would have been brought in here and interrogated.
Look at me, Yumi, just like, loo, 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 loo.
I didn't want to put her through that. And?
And?
Mom never liked Tessa. So maybe, just maybe, Mom hired someone to kill Tessa. And she gave them that kitchen knife. I don't know. I thought of it that way. Like that would ever happen.
Mom's crazy. Everybody's crazy.
I know it sounds crazy, but after I saw that knife, I just... lost it. Please, you have to believe me. Mom isn't a serial killer.
Yeah, I agree.
You do?
I do. I don't think it's possible for Mayumi to have kidnapped Iris. Because...
Yeah. Because there's no... there was not any DNA in this, right?
Two cars were parked in front of the warehouse.
None of her DNA was in that.
One was the van owned by the Matsushita family. Ota's fingerprints were detected on the driver's seat and steering wheel. Iris's fingerprints were detected on the passenger seat. The other car was a station wagon. Yesterday, at 10:33 p.m., Ota stole this station wagon. It was parked at the Famisto along Koshu Highway. Ota explained his reasoning for stealing the car. He claims that while he was inside the Famisto, someone took off with the van, with Iris still inside. Ota decided to steal the station wagon parked nearby to give pursuit. Ota searched for the van in his stolen vehicle. Our investigation determined that Iris and the van were taken 1 minute before Ota stole the station wagon. This puts the incident occurring at 10:32 p.m.
Guys, there was no, like, footage of, like, the van getting stolen outside the... I mean, we saw Oda stealing the car, but we didn't see who, like, drove off in the van that had Iris in it?
A video camera and laptop were discovered in the warehouse. Either could have been left by the criminal, but determining the owner through purchase history will be difficult. No fingerprints were picked up either.
I'll claim it couldn't be Miyumi, because there's no way she could know how to work this shit.
Okiura Fishery is a company owned by Mizuki's grandfather. However, the management team changed 17 years ago. It currently has no connections to the Okiura family. And allegedly, Mizuki's grandfather was raised by dolphins.
Yes. That was very, very significant. Okay. Oh, this alone is not enough. Oh, okay, yes. It's the cars and the chocolate.
The Matsushita's van was stolen from the parking lot of the Famista while Iris was in the car. That was yesterday, 10:32 p.m. 1 minute later at the 812, which was about 100 yards away, Mayumi bought the Odoriki Man chocolate. She entered the 812 about a minute earlier, This was all caught on security cameras at the store. That means it's impossible that Mayumi could have taken the van.
Oh, we actually had that on camera too? Then why did I even need to give a shit about that? I guess the point was we didn't have any reason to check the footage beyond that, right? We were looking at Oda's thing. We're not really paying attention to anyone just going in the store normally. We're like, oh yeah, there's Oda stealing the car. But then when we saw, oh, this was bought by Mayumi at the store. Now we had a reason to go check it out, but we just didn't bring it up till now.
And that means that Mayumi being the polar bear is also next to impossible.
Phew.
However, I can't completely clear her.
What?
You said it yourself. She could have hired someone to commit the crime.
Yeah.
But that was...
In any case, I need to hear from Mayumi herself. I need to hear her explain the chocolate, the knife. There's a lot to cover.
If she remembers at all.
I'm gonna head to Matsushita Diner.
What? Hey, wait a minute.
Don't worry. I'm not going there to arrest her. I'm going there to clear her of suspicion.
Really?
Yes.
You won't arrest her?
Your mother wouldn't kill anyone, right, Ota?
Thank you, Date.
I'm gonna arrest her.
Say to the boss.
All right, see you guys.
Matsushita Diner.
Sorry for the late night, Miss Matsushita, but I have some questions I need to ask you. Could you spare some time?
I'm pouty.
I finally remembered about the warehouse. I did it. I did everything.
Oh. Okay, never mind. You're under arrest. Well, that was easy. Case solved, guys. Day 5, Tuesday. Hey, guy. You got what on?
I didn't do this last night because I wanted to give you a chance to calm down. How are you, now that you've slept on it?
What am I doing here, damn it?
What are you talking about?
I'll be honest, I don't think you're the killer. You're giving us a false confession.
No, it's true. I kidnapped that witch, I took her to the warehouse, and...
Put her on the table and pulled her eyeball out?
Yeah.
Yes.
Yeah, fuck her.
And the polar bear costume?
I bought it through mail order.
It's a big-ass box it came in.
And you were the one wearing it?
Yes, that's right.
Date, the criminal has confessed. Arrest her immediately.
You got to the top of Abyss acting like that?
I heard that she used to be an actress.
Sounds about right.
Mayumi looks tense. She looks pissed. Why did you kidnap Iris?
My son is under that witch's spell.
She needed the demon die!
Merchandise, concerts. She's bleeding him dry. I wanted to snap him out of it. I wanted to save him.
That's why I snapped the fuck out of him. Boom!
Why'd you take her eye out?
Because I just hated her so much. Killing her wasn't enough.
She had to feel pain!
Were you the one who stabbed Oda?
You were in the polar bear costume, right? That means you stabbed him.
Yes, I stabbed him with the knife I brought from home. I wasn't trying to hurt him. He fought me, and then it just...
You're so full of shit, lady. Why'd you stream it online?
Because the world needs to see that witch die.
Yeah!
Just a quick question, Mayumi. Do you know anything about online streaming?
I'm not stupid. I might be old, but...
Could you explain it to me?
Huh?
Step by step. Just tell me what you did.
I can't explain it in words. It's more like... muscle memory. I was able to get it working after trying a few times, that's all.
Where'd you get the camera and the laptop? Tell me.
Picked them out of the garbage.
Which garbage?
I don't remember.
Some nice equipment someone just tossed out.
It's true. I planned the whole thing.
About the Cyclops killings.
What do you know about the Cyclops killer? We call the criminal we're after the new Cyclops killer.
I know. They killed Shoko Nadami and Renju Okiura.
That's right.
I did that shit too. God dang it.
Both corpses were found with their left eye pulled out. Same as Iris. This leads us to believe that the crimes were all committed by the same person. So this person in the polar bear costume, they are the new Cyclops killer. And you're telling me that person is you? You killed Choco and Renju?
Yes, I killed them.
Yeah, sure.
Why are you lying to me?
I am not lying.
You do know that perjury is a crime, right?
I'm telling you, I'm not lying. I killed Choco and Renju, and I tried to cut that demon witch in half.
What was your motive?
Isn't Renju Okiura the president of that awful company where the witch works?
Yeah.
He's just as responsible. Using her to steal time and money from vulnerable kids.
Yeah.
And I'm sure he was debaucherous and degenerate.
Yeah.
That man is the root of all evil. That's why I killed him.
Okay. Why'd you kill Choco?
Renju's ex-wife, right? I did it to get to him.
But the two divorced 4 years ago.
That doesn't matter. The bonds of matrimony are eternal.
In your opinion, I don't think Renju felt the same way.
Give a fuck about her.
You are really starting to aggravate me. I answered your questions, so there.
When and how did you kill her?
Well, I don't remember.
What do you mean you don't remember? Do you really think that lie is gonna work?
I've got dementia, bitch!
I have a memory disorder. I don't always remember everything. It's not my fault.
But you remember the cold storage warehouse.
There are times I remember and times I don't remember. It changes.
Date, Mayumi is not lying about that in particular. There are circumstances that might cause selective memory. For whatever reason, her memory might not have been stored properly in her mind. This is not uncharacteristic for those suffering from dementia.
Shut up, Ira!
Date, there's no point in letting this go on. She's clearly lying.
You seemed convinced earlier.
I was kidding. I don't think she's the killer.
I am the killer! I am!
Damn it all!
Right now, we have to rely on hard evidence.
So it makes you think that she's trying to protect Oda, right? But does that mean she thinks what I was thinking earlier, that Oda, like, stabbed himself or some shit? The way that Oda did it, like, described it, it doesn't seem like that'd be the case, right? He was clearly resistant to tell us about it because he saw the knife that belonged to his mom. But she seems so like, yeah, I did it. But then why wouldn't she, like, if she really was responsible for it, even if it was like she hired somebody else, why wouldn't she say that, right? I gave him the knife and they went and killed him.
The Odoroki Man chocolate that Mayumi bought was found at the warehouse.
If Mayumi was at the scene before Ota,
she may have seen the criminal's face.
You know what I'm going to say, right?
Somnium again?
Date, sync with her.
Damn, we're wow. Okay, it's been like 5 minutes since I've synced with somebody. Yeah, let's go ahead and do it again. Jesus Christ, okay. Wasn't expecting to do another one so soon. Knock her out.
Pewter, we're going to sync with Mayumi Matsushita. Prepare the machine.
Oh, this one's probably going to be really... I bet it's going to be all over the place, right? Because her mind is already scattered.
What happened? The sync machine isn't operating to capacity. Yesterday's sync... Well, suffice to say, Oda and Date were not too compatible.
It's because I fucking hate Oda. He stays me and hit me in the walk.
Compatible?
I mean, walked me.
I'll give you the big picture. To get the synchronization working properly, I had to push the machine pretty hard. And now, it's not responding.
How long will it take to fix?
16 hours, at least.
You've got 8.
But that's impossible.
So we can't sync yet, huh?
But we need to, or this investigation is going nowhere.
Yeah, fuck it.
Date. I suggest we go to Matsushita Diner. We may be able to find some clues.
Good idea.
I was getting hungry too. Don't make that look, Pooter. I'll let Boston Pooter know.
Pewter, we're counting on you for those repairs.
I'll be back in 6 hours.
It better be done by then!
But you said 8.
Now it's 5!
Please, you have to give me at least 8.
That pewter. Always so humble. He'll have it done in 6.
He'll have it done in 4.
Yeah, pewter is just that kind of guy, you know?
Hey! This is a hostile work environment!
You chose to work here, piece of shit! Now go to work! Whatch! Get him a Mustang! Woo!
Why would Mayumi lie?
She is probably protecting someone.
But who?
Surely you know by now. There is only one person Mayumi would want to protect that badly.
Right. I know, the glove box. Okay, I don't think I'm gonna find anything funny because we're talking serious. All right, obviously it's fucking sausage. Obviously she loves Iris. No, Mizuki. It's Ota.
It's Ota.
It has to be.
Does Mayumi think Ota is the killer?
Last night, Ota left Matsushita Diner with Iris. Mayumi saw the whole thing.
But Ota was stabbed in the stomach by the culprit. Does Mayumi not remember that?
No, that isn't quite it. It is possible that she thinks Ota is responsible for everything.
It's possible she thinks what Nico thought last couple of episodes.
She thinks Ota stabbed himself?
Yeah.
Yes.
Why would he do that?
I don't know, Nico. Why would he?
Because he's a simp. Simp out, bitch.
Before I explain, I would like to hear your thoughts. What do you think about the possibility that Ota is the new Cyclops killer?
Impossible.
Why?
And yesterday, Somnium, Ota, and the polar bear. Iris had her eye taken out. The van stolen at Famisto. Let's go with that.
The van was stolen while Iris was in the passenger seat. We know that whoever did it is the culprit we're looking for.
There is a chance that Iris was not in the passenger seat. She could have been driving.
Yep.
How so?
Iris could have taken the wheel herself and driven to the warehouse.
But forensics only found Ota's fingerprints on the wheel.
That can be explained. It is possible that Iris covered her fingertips with her sleeves.
Okay. Next is a Somnium, Ota and the polar bear. They wrestled.
Yesterday's Somnium, Ota and the polar bear.
That was just a dream.
Yeah.
It doesn't necessarily reflect what happened in reality.
It's just some like dumb anime Ota made up.
Iris had her eye taken out.
Iris had her left eye pulled out. Ota would never do that.
Have you considered that she pulled it out herself?
Yeah, it's pretty easy, actually. I've done it before.
What?
Or even asked Ota to do it.
See, she's thinking what I was thinking! Fuck yeah! High five, Abba!
Perhaps she ordered him to.
Yeah.
I understand, Abba.
In short, Ota and Iris are accomplices. This was all a performance.
A performance?
Iris drove the Matsushita's van. Ota drove the station wagon. They went to the warehouse separately. Then, they prepared the live stream. Iris anesthetized her left eye and removed it. Either that, or she asked Ota to extract it.
It was awesome.
After that, Iris took her position on the table, and Ota donned the polar bear costume and started the saw. Consider this.
I like this is exactly what I was thinking. This is exactly the theory I had. Yeah.
In the stream, Ota and the polar bear were never on screen at the same time.
Yeah.
True. That means Ota went off camera, took off the costume, and then...
Stay away from Tessa!
Shut up, Ota. How many times am I going to hear you say that?
Perhaps Mayumi witnessed the entire event. It is also possible that Mayumi knew what the two were up to.
So she lied to protect Ota.
Yes, but this is only a theory.
On the other timeline, Ota got chopped to shit, put in the polar bear outfit, and Mia just like sat there and watched it. She's like, damn, Ota, you're really going all out for this girl. I'm proud of you, boy. You're such a good son. Why would they do that?
Consider the possibility that Iris killed Shoko and Renju.
Then, this whole thing was to get her off the suspects list. That's why she pulled out her eye and had Ota stab himself.
Yeah.
It makes it look like there's another criminal involved.
Yeah.
I will repeat myself in saying that this is only a theory.
A Nico theory. Thanks for watching.
It is one of many possibilities.
It's possible, but I don't think it's very likely.
Chef Date, no, it's totally true.
They wouldn't go that far just to avoid suspicion.
Date, you must consider the mental state of the serial killer.
These two are fucking crazy!
Shoko and Renju were both exposed and displayed. And they both had their left eye removed while they were still alive. Whoever that killer is, it is clear that they are sociopathic or even psychotic.
Nah, maybe sociopath, but not psychotic. No, not at all from this.
He said with extreme sarcasm.
Can't rule anything out.
You know what? Even if it doesn't end up being right, I'm glad they fucking said that. I am. That at least just makes me feel a little better. Like, that was shit wasn't out of absolute fucking nowhere. I mean, even let's say this shit is exactly what fucking Uchikoshi wanted me to think this whole time. I'm just falling right into his little web. I'm so happy to hear the characters actually mention it, you know? Because it could have been a thing where, like, that's what he wanted me to think, but he didn't tell me that's what he wanted me to think. And then I just think like I'm a fucking crazy person. Well, at least I go, you know what? That is a viable theory, sort of, maybe, until we find something that makes it that shows it probably isn't possible. Let's see. I'm gonna walk in here, there's another fucking dead body.
Ota.
Uh-oh.
Why are you...
Don't stab me.
Why did you arrest Mom? You said you were gonna clear her!
I am!
Why?
Hi, kitty.
Oda's still looking pissed.
I didn't do it, all right? I had to bring her in. She's like, I murder people.
I'm like, oh, okay, that's cool. Anyway, can I have the Sunday special?
God, every time I walk in here now, someone's sitting in this thing with a fucking picture frame and they're super pissed at me.
Well, I think we're pretty far to this episode. I still want to keep going, but I think we're going to have to end things here for now, guys. Okay, where are we on the flowchart at this moment? Are we still in that same... Yeah, we're not that far from the branch off point. Well, we reached day 5, which is where I got locked off in the other one. I will say it's extended out pretty damn far. I do wonder how far will this game branch out, you know? How many different breakout points will I get? But anyway, guys, I hope you all enjoy this episode. If you did, please leave a like and a favorite and subscribe for an already Gumpy Penguin. Aboard the SLP, where the days are always sunny and the vids are always funny. I don't know what to think anymore. The game's throwing a lot of different possibilities at me. Even my own theory. I think it might just be throwing that out there to show maybe what Miyumi thinks. But if Miyumi was there, I mean, right? It's kind of hard to imagine that Miyumi would have seen Oda like stab the shit out of himself and not have intervened or done something. Or watch him get stabbed by somebody and not intervene. So it's just kind of weird that, like, what? How does it explain that she would be sitting there watching them all the way to completion, but then be gone by that point, you know? Unless she was the killer, but it doesn't seem like that's the case either. It seems like she's lying. I don't know where this shit's going. It's just getting crazy. Hopefully we'll maybe figure it out next episode. But anyway, guys, as always, till next time, stay classy.